Stewart, but he's been replaced. No, he couldn't replace
him. No, I'm deputising.
Deputising. Thank you, Chris. And then we move on to code of conduct declarations of interest. And we have several minutes to look at, starting with the 4th of October.
This report just updates the committee on the proposed recruitment exercise for additional independent persons. The working group considered the person specification, job description, along with the recruitment process and procedure, which this report sets out. It's for the committee to confirm its approval for those arrangements in order for the recruitment exercise to be undertaken. We have a number of independent persons. It's always prudent to have a significant or reasonable pool of independent persons that we're looking for, and it's hoped that we'll attract a similar calibre independent persons as we have been previously fortunate to attract, and this exercise will be undertaken as soon as you are happy to proceed.
Yes.
someone who's an independent vendor who doesn't bother showing up, then what's the point?
No, absolutely, and we can look at that issue, and maybe that's something that we can look at in terms of the future of recruitment that we would require their attendance, and we can look at how we ensure that the arrangements are sufficient in that regard, so that members are satisfied that independent people do attend and are engaged in the process as we expect.
So,
can I ask,
should members, is it a male or a female?
Yes, and only works full time, so that's always sometimes part of the difficulty, but I appreciate the understanding that if you are questioning his period of attendance and carpet at all the last time you attended, then clearly that's something I can pick up with the individuals as well, so that you can address that issue going forward.
Okay.
And just to make sure this is the reason why we do want to be to make sure that we have sufficient people that we know caught out in terms of not having independent people available.
Okay, do that in your hands.
This is a recommendation from the working group.
Chair, before you, the recommendations are set out at page 29 with regards to the recruitment exercise. The committee is asked to approve both of those recommendations appearing at page 29.
Agreed.
Agreed.
Fine. Thank
you. So we can move on to item 5. Draft members ICT policy, page
24. Mr. Chair, through you again, this was considered by the working group on that speaking on the 10th of October. It updates the current policy with regards to information ICT security, with regards to members' use of electronic devices and handling information electronically. It deals with data protection and the role of the ICO. It essentially sets out matters that members are aware of and what they currently do. It does update the arrangements to bring it in line with recommendations from the ICO in regards to ICT policy. As they've been discussed and considered working with previously and before committee for approval today.
Members' comments?
I think we're read through it line by line. Chair, so I'm happy to approve it.
So, if everybody's agreed, item 6, page 55, is the draft Mayor's Charity Terms of Reference.
Yes, again, through you, Chair. We are currently undertaking a review of the Mayor's Charity Arrangements, and one of the issues, one of the arrangements that we have in place is the committee that assists the Mayor in the charity events and arrangements. The terms of reference of that committee have been updated to make it clearer and more robust in terms of the arrangements. There is a much broader review being undertaken with regards to the Mayor's Charity. We are using the current suggested model trust document and arrangements for the Charity Commission, and there will be a further report brought back to the working group with regards to proposed revisions to the Mayor's Charity as well as the committee, which are consistent with and in line with the good practice arrangements and suggestions of the Charity Commission. So this just basically provides an update on the current arrangements, but a more comprehensive review being undertaken and will be brought back to the working group and in future back to this committee.
Wrong.
Yes, briefly, Chair. Is this resulting such a draft reapproving the delay from the terms of reference?
Yes.
Pending a further review of those mutual members.
Yes.
But we've already sent it out. Disagree with the other terms of reference.
Green?
Yeah,
green.
Thank you.
It's a recommendation if you agree to council side. It is not to council.
Thank you.
Chair, this is Amendment 2 Standing Orders, just to address an inconsistency between two particular Standing Order provisions, which are set out in the agenda, agenda item 9. The amendment just simply brings both provisions in line so that members, any three members of the committee, as well as two spokespersons, can request an extraordinary meeting or special meeting of the committee. And that can be arranged, or that is to be arranged as far as practically possible in the following days.
Once again, we're on the disclosable.
Do you want me to vote in
the changes?
The changes. And you can do it in one. Just title. Three committee members have the same opportunity as the chair or two spokes in terms of timing of the meetings. It's not asking anything else. It's already in the constitution that three members can call a meeting. This was his timing. By voting against, you won't stop three members calling a meeting.
It's just saying it could be organised within 14 days.
That's all
we're trying to say. It's stop it going on.
If we're going to explain, we called a special meeting of the screening committee, the bargaining committee, a while ago. But because three committee members called it, there's no timing on when that meeting should take place.
There's no time in this recommendation.
But does it say within 14 days?
On page 71. Page 71.
Not on part of the recommendation.
Should be in the recommendation.
It's set out at page 71, because what page 71 and 73 sets out the extract.
Existing.
Shows what we call what's proposed.
So if you look at 2 on the first page, 71, what is 2 is existing, and proposed 2 is just making that 14 days, so that there's no ambiguity. That's all it's trying to do.
Yeah.
Well, it's not what it's
trying to do. The voice of Councillor Abbey was asking whether the 26.2, which is referred to in part 1 on the summons page, it talks about the proposed changes to Council Orders 26.2, 35.8 and 35.9. So 26.2, the proposed change, is covered on page 71 in the right-hand column.
Yes.
Yes, that's the point.
We're not asking for three members to be allowed to call a meeting. That already exists. I think what we're doing is just saying if two spokes call a meeting, it's held in 14 days.
Yeah, it's
14 days. Yeah,
just trying to target. This provision effectively just makes two provisions that are currently inconsistent in the constitution consistent. Yeah. So you can call a meeting under one, whereby two spokes and 14 days is applicable. There's another provision which allows three members of the committee, but doesn't have the time for that. So it effectively just aligns the two arrangements.
Okay. Can I just clarify, Chair? Also, the point about 14 days, as I understand it, that's not written in tablets of stone. It does say, as opposed to, or as soon as we...
Yes.
If there's a good reason why it couldn't be held within 14 days, it could be held.
But that's same for whether it's two spokes, the chair, or three members.
We were trying to avoid a situation, Chair, where it got lost and disappeared in the hinterlands.
Yes, and 14 days is quite challenging